Hey there, welcome to week three, part two, and this is just a brief overview on how to do the assignment. So real quick, just so you know, it says quiz, it's not a quiz, it's an assignment. We just had to format it, it's Canvas. But yeah, it's just week three, part two, grammar writing assignment. So tasks for week three, part two. You're going to take grammar notes, the slideshow is below. You're going to answer 5 multiple choice questions. Those will be graded. And you're going to provide a character analysis as well. And that is your writing portion, which will also be graded for this week. So the required work to be graded is to complete all multiple choice questions and complete the written response. And like I mentioned before last week, when you're doing the writing portion of this, I would definitely have a Google Doc open for you and also have Grammarly. The reason being is that I actually made this whole assignment in Canvas and then the internet crashed and I had to do the whole assignment again. If you open up the Google Doc and your internet shuts down, you are okay because it constantly saves it into the cloud. And then Grammarly also is a spell checker and grammar checker for you as well. So let's go ahead and look at the grammar notes. So take notes over the slideshow. I have a video here. And if you want to, same as with week three, part one, in terms of like tone, if you right click the YouTube button and open a new tab, I broke this video down into sections with tone, word choice, and connotation and denotation. So that's you right there if you don't want to watch the video. And then I also have the resources that we had last week for, you know, paragraph and MLA resources. You click on it, you can look at the, you know, paragraph formatting and also how to cite properly as well. But let's go ahead and get back to week three, part one. Question one. So it's basically you trying to decide which is either a positive, negative, or neutral connotation. And we discussed that in the slideshow. I also break it down in the video as well. But it's 5 multiple choice questions. Just so you know, everyone has different questions. I made it that way to mix it up. And then question 6 is the writing prompt itself. And you just need to copy and paste, either, you know, type it here and risk having the possibility of having the internet shut down or Canvas glitching out on you, or you write this on a Google document and then copy and paste it into the document. So writing prompt, character analysis, reading materials right here. And then if you want, I also have the notes as a link as well. Just another warning, I would do this in Google Docs, but you do you. Prompt. Write an analysis of a key character in a literary work. So you could choose either The Lottery, or you could do There Will Come Soft Rains, and just do a character in there. So a character doesn't have to be a person in There Will Come Soft Rains. If you need help with that and you want to really do a character analysis in that story, we can also define what are some characters in there. Make sure you cite properly in MLA format and have well-developed paragraphs, which means at least 5 sentences each. So paragraph 1, write an analysis of a key character in a literary work. Again, either The Lottery or There All Comes Soft Rains. Describe 2 or 3 key actions of the character or how the character responds to events. What do the events reveal about the character and what do the actions say about the character's emotional and mental capacity? So if you need help, I have some sentence starters here. But what I've done, last week I gave, you know, more sentence frames and how to cite properly. You can still look at the module there. It's linked on the very bottom right here. But that's paragraph number 1. And then for paragraph number 2, analyze the character's background. So, you know, what are they, like where they grew up, location, you might not know. And how does the why does the character act in the way that they do? And how does the author's characterization in the text reflect the psychological background? So you're kind of looking at background. Maybe, you know, you look at the setting of, you know, what did they, you know, what was the environment that they built into? Who, what, when, and where? And how does that influence who they are today? and how does it reflect their psychological capabilities? The lottery, if you need help, we can break it down a little bit more, but I want you to read the story first before we, you know, really break it down. And with There Will Come Soft Rains, we could also look at personifying or anthropomorphizing some of the characters in the story, since they aren't directly human. But we could look at, like, the concept, and maybe we look at the psychological background of other characters there as well. Same thing with paragraph one. Here's some sentence starters to help you out. If you want more help, please see me, or maybe I'll have a meeting as well during the week for that. Rubric right here, it's the same as last week. And again, paragraph and MLA resources. This is where you type your response. And then, again, I would open up a new document or open up a new tab, have Google Doc open, and then respond and copy and paste it here. And then you click Submit Quiz. That is week three, part two. And that's all you would have to do. So make sure you write the two-paragraph response for part two and make sure you answer all five of the multiple choice questions. That is it for week three. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact me or meet me during one of the conferences next week. Good luck and stay safe.